There was once a time when trains traveled almost completely around the island of Puerto Rico. There were multiple trains used to move people, cargo, and sugarcane from place to place. But that all ended in the 1950s, and today almost nothing remains of the railroad system that once dominated the island. The story began with horse-drawn trams in Mayagüez in 1875. That were used to transport passengers. It was followed a few years later by a steam tramway between the capital, San Juan, and the town of Rio Piedras. Both systems were later electrified and the San Juan system expanded. However, it wasn't until the late 19th century until the main railroad system on the island was constructed due to the booming sugar industry. This system would be used for both passengers and freight. Its origins can be traced back to 1874, when a Spanish engineer proposed building a steam railroad line along the coast of Puerto Rico, connecting from San Juan to Ponce. Construction began in 1888, and although it would take almost 20 years to complete, the first section, which was the northern line from San Juan to Manati, began operations in 1891. This was followed by extensions to the towns of Carolina and Arecibo the following year. When the United States invaded Puerto Rico in 1898, the island already had around 168 miles of railroad tracks. Following U.S. annexation of the island, the railroads were taken over in 1902 by the American Railroad of Puerto Rico. And the following years, Puerto Rico's railroad network consisted of several key lines. The northern line connecting San Juan to other northern towns. The eastern line linking San Juan to Fajardo, an important port for sugar and general cargo. The southern line extending from Ponce to various towns and agricultural regions in the south. And several other branch lines serving specific agricultural or industrial purposes. As the railroad network expanded across the island, several tunnels and bridges were constructed to facilitate the movement of trains through mountainous terrain. These tunnels and bridges were essential for connecting different regions and overcoming geographical obstacles. At its peak, this network spanned roughly 300 miles, connecting major towns across the island. These railroads played a pivotal role in the island's economy, transporting agricultural goods, facilitating passenger travel, and supporting industrial growth. However, by the 1950s, the rise of automobiles and improved road infrastructure diminished the demand for rail transport. Economic pressures and the high costs of maintaining aging infrastructure further contributed to the decline of the traditional railroads. Many lines became obsolete or economically unviable, leading to their closure or abandonment. Despite the decline of traditional railroads, Puerto Rico saw a resurgence in rail transport with the construction of the Tren Urbano, inaugurated in 2004. The Tren Urbano is a modern rapid transit system serving the San Juan metropolitan area. It connects various urban centers and suburbs, providing efficient transportation for residents and reducing congestion on roads. Currently, efforts to preserve Puerto Rico's railroad heritage have focused on maintaining and restoring historical railway stations, artifacts, and sections of track. Many former railroad stations also serve as museums for the people on the island and tourists. These preservation initiatives aim to honor the island's history and educate future generations about the importance of railroads in shaping Puerto Rico's history and economy. Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Help us to spread this video by sharing. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell for more videos.